All right, we got the Lexus. Yeah, we got the garbage man. And yeah, the CT today, yeah, is a CT day.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Welcome back to the channel. Yeah, we're gonna take the CT200 Lexus of Fremont, check out some other Lexuses while we're there, and yeah, we'll see what we get into. Fremont Auto Row. So we got, yeah, Toyota right across the street, Chevy, Honda, Mercedes, Porsche, all in one area. Look at Toyota. Look how empty that is. That lot is crazy empty. This used to all be full. Porsche has always kind of been like a smaller lot and not a bad amount, but same with BMW. Anyways, yeah, Toyota, super, super empty. Yeah, Lexus doing well. Good amount of inventory. Yeah, this RCF is super sick. See if we can focus there. Yeah, that is nice. Got a nice red one up front too. Check this out. We got a better look at the red Lexus that was out here. Well, they're all Lexus, but the RCF thing looks really sick. And it's so funny because just by coincidence, we have our friend Joel's Lexus right in front of us, the RCF as well. But yeah, we got a better look at the side of the RCF. Super nice. Look at how the calipers match. That thing is so sick. We had like a guys in maintenance staring at me like, what is he doing? But yeah, super dope. Yeah, people in line. We'll go check out Joel's. Here goes Joel's car. Yeah, sitting right in front of my CT. All right, in the showroom, and look, we have a Carrera 4S. I think this is a 997. Yeah, look at that. PDK, all carbon fiber on the steering wheel and the shift knob as well. And then a C8 Corvette in a similar color. Well, no, not really. It's more like a burgundy-ish. Yeah, look at the back of the C8. I think it's sick. A super nice G-Wagon too. This is actually not a bad price. They're asking for 79. It's in really clean condition. Look at those wheels. That's definitely off of something else. And yeah, look at the carbon fiber on the steering wheel. Super clean, really nice condition. The only thing, of course, I would want in a manual transmission, of course, PDK is one of the better dual clutches out there, but still just a preference. Also in the showroom, got an ES350, really nice color. And of course, what you would expect from the interior of a Lexus, super nice and luxurious. LC500 up front in display, but yeah, convertible. Wouldn't want a convertible. I'd take it if the price was right though. Yeah, look at that, just menacing. Super nice. All right, in the back of a RX. And I am not focusing, there we are. Yeah, they got the music blasting outside. They got some Beatles going, but yeah, love the Beatles, but yeah, I'll get demonetized if I have that music playing in the background. Anyways, yeah, look at that steering wheel. Super nice, sporty, because it's the F-Sport version of the RX, and this is way different from our RX at home. Very, very nice. All right, this is one thing I'm happy to see from the dealership here, is that here on the side, you've probably been seeing videos from other dealerships saying that they have huge markups for pretty much no reason. And you see here, they just got the clear shield on it, a few more $1,000. But look, the MSRP is 55, they're asking 56. So that's not bad at all. These guys are doing really well. They're not messing around. They're just trying to get the deals done and not screw anyone over, really. And here's a G-Wagon that they have in display. Really nice, all black, black on everything. And except for the calipers, they got brake dust. That's how they're black a little bit. All right, climbing into the ES. I'm really close with this lens, but at least you can get a closer look at the details in a brand new Lexus ES. I mean, honestly, it looks really good. The materials are super nice, but from just memory, the RX that we were in earlier and this, I can't think of a big difference. Maybe I'm just not remembering right, but I guess what I'm trying to say is that the look overall is pretty much the same. It goes with a lot of manufacturers, right? Outside of Lexus of Fremont, and there are a few used cars here worth mentioning for sure. The SQ5 Audi, the Range Rover, the Land Rover, Mercedes-Benz. This is, yeah, luxury row right here. This one, yeah, the windows are too tinted to see inside, but it's all like quilted interior, which is really nice. This one, I don't know if you guys can tell, but there's like almost like a blue tint
to the windshield. I don't know if that's factory or if they added that in afterwards. Oh, nice white interior in this one. Super luxurious. And for the Mercedes, yeah, what you would expect from a Benz. Yeah, hard to see because of the reflection, but you can imagine what's in there. Give you another angle of the Land Rover. I think it's really nice. And then another one for me that I think is worth mentioning is this M4. Super nice interior on this one. Really hard to tell because of the shadows, but yeah, carbon fiber throughout all the trim. And then you got red interior on this one. This one is the hardtop convertible. Really cool. Really gives Sal and Ellie vibes. There's an S5 here as well. I'm wondering how much these go for. 58, and it's a 2019. So yeah, I'm not too familiar with Audis, but I would imagine 58 is a good price for a 2019. Don't know the mileage or anything like that, but really nice. Also up front, we got a Zed. Yeah, this one's going for 35. It looks like it has a nice exhaust on there. Some black wheels. This would be really cool for someone to have. The windows are super dark. I can barely see in there. I can't even tell if it's stick shift or not. And then we also have a couple of Teslas here. I think that one's going for 51. This one 41. Something like that. And that's a 2019. That's a 2016. This should show you that this one holds its value a lot more than that one. But then again, I really don't know like the specs. And the 2021 Accord, man, I don't know. Without that Honda emblem there, if it was like a European brand or something like that, I would say this actually looks really good. Very nice color, really nice headlights on it as well. And then something I don't give a lot attention to, I don't know why, it just turns out that way, but this Challenger, super nice. And you got the, a honeybee or something like that? Got the Hemi. I know it's a Hemi because it's telling us it's a Hemi. And then something I was actually considering when I was looking at my LS is the C300. Just wanted something luxury, and yeah, can't go wrong with Mercedes. It actually is a very nice car. And it's a C-Class. Yeah, I'd definitely take this over this one. And up front in the circle, this is actually where we saw Joel's car back when it wasn't his car. And yeah, a C43 AMG. These things sound nice. I don't know if this is a wrap, if this is the way they come. I think this is the way it comes. Sort of like a matte or a satin finish to it. Super nice. Man, this would be really nice to have. And again, just like all these other cars, the windows are super tinted, so we can't really see inside. But this one's going for 56. And right behind it, yeah, that might be someone that works here, so I won't video that too much, but really nice Ford indeed. Look at this Fox body run on Dayton's. Man, that is old school. That is super cool. Oh, right back in the CT. She's all done, and yeah, it is getting busy here. Gonna head out. All right, looks like Joel's car is coming up next. And as per tradition, we are going to Porsche. Just drive by, pretend I'm lost, like I always do. No one ever really says anything, but look, I'm in the market for electric. What about Paycon? Ooh, look at that blue, really nice. Oh, Hungry Blue, man, you got competition. Ooh, man, check these out. Oh, those are nice. Damn, GT3 in the white. Okay, I need to get out of here. I'm not supposed to be back here. Ooh, look at that, we found a gem. Okay, it's not really a gem. It just looks really cool though. Look at that purple. That thing's a trip. Super nice. That purple, the darkness, that's nice. Oh, but seriously, you know what? Driving by that Porsche dealership has me thinking, if we're thinking electric, you know, selling the LS 430 and getting something electric, how cool will it be to not have a Tesla, but instead have a Taycan? Like, seriously. Yeah, I gotta start doing the math on this and see what we can do. Anyways, I haven't ended a video by talking to you guys in a long time. I've just been lazy. It's not like I'm trying to change the format of how I do the videos. But anyways, if you guys like the video, make sure to give that a thumbs up. Share with anyone that might like this type of content. I don't know who would. And I'll talk to you guys later.